Welcome to another session of Hardware Engineering. From today's session, we will be beginning with a new chapter, that is Hardware Maintenance, which is chapter number 7. So let's begin with this new chapter and the new topics. The first topic which we are going to learn is the beach profile, that are the various components of a beach. So this is the layout of the profile of a beach. We will be learning the labels of each and every component which exists in this profile. So let's begin from the leftmost part. Firstly is bluff or escarpment. Now bluff or escarpment is a slope which is connecting two horizontal surfaces, that is berms. So first of all, berms, that is the horizontal surface which has been shown. Bluff or escarpment is a slope which is connecting these berms. Again, there is a beach scarp. Beach scarp is also a slope which is connecting two berms or two horizontal surfaces. But the difference is that it is of a very small height, while the bluff is of a considerable height. So the difference is regarding the height, while the similarity is that both are slope. Next, crest of berm is the topmost point of the berm. Crest, we know, is the topmost point. So crest is the topmost point of berm. Ordinary low water level, which indicates the low water level, that is the height of the water in the situation of low water. And high water level, that is the water level which is high, that is when there is the maximum amount of water level, that is high water level, and minimum, that is the low water level, which will be the average value or the mean value for a certain duration. Next, this bottom is the seabed, that is ultimately the foundation. Breakers are also called as wave breaking, are the waves which are of high, sort of a considerable height, which have very high energy as well. Basically, breakers are those waves which have reached their amplitude. If I correlate with sort of an example of a pendulum, then in that case amplitude is the maximum displacement. Here amplitude is with reference to the height. So basically the breakers, that are the wave breaking, are those waves which have reached a critical value, that is which are of very high energy and which are of considerable height as well. That are the breakers. Plunge point is the head point after which the waves are breaking. That is, on the left hand side of the plunge point, there will be no breaking waves, that is no high energy waves. On the right side will be the breakers or the wave breaking, that will be the waves with a considerable energy and of considerable height as well. Next are the coast, which is the land portion of the beach. Beach or shore is that portion of land which will come in contact with the water. So beach or shore is that portion which will come in contact with water. Coast will not come in contact with water. It is farther away from the water portion. Back shore and foreshore. Foreshore is that region which varies between low water level and high water level. If we extend this line, it will pass through the low water level. So foreshore is that portion between low water level and high water level. Backshore is that portion which will come in contact with water only in the condition of high water level. So backshore normally has sediments and normally does not have the water component or water reaching that specific region, but only in case of high water level, water will reach the portion of back. Surf zone is that zone in which the surf or the surf waves will be created. Surf waves are those waves which have low height and more length. So length is more and the height of wave is less. You might have also seen the adventure sport of surfing, in which on a plank the rider is moving on the waves. So they are of a considerable length, but the height of the wave is less. Next is offshore, which is a considerable depth of water and where the breaking of waves won't take place. So offshore is sort of a region having considerable depth of water. Inshore or shore face, which extends through the breaker zone, that is it has a region in which wave breaking will take place. So basically, inshore or shore face is having a certain specific zone of wave breaking, and in rest of the zone wave breaking won't take place. Coastal area is the total profile, and the near shore zone basically indicates that region which is in vicinity to the shore. So we have discussed each and every level. Basically, these are the various components in the layout of the beach. Next topic are the coastal protection works. Now, basically, this topic deals with which various structures can be constructed for the protection of the coast, for the protection of the beach. So, these are the various structures which will aid or help in maintaining the profile and maintaining the layout of the coast, and to make sure that no erosion of the coast is taking place. Shoreline undergoes continuous change due to effect of tide, winds, waves, or storms. So the layout is constantly under the attack by the tides, winds, waves, storms. It might change the profile. Thus, shore protection works are needed. It might change the profile or where these effects are of high intensity. It might also sort of devastate the profile of the coast. Various shore protection works are mentioned here. We will be discussing in detail each and every shore protection work. The first coast protection work is sea wall. So basically, this is a wall which is demarcating the land portion and the water portion. So this is the area or space where the movement of human activity can take place, transportation of cargo or commodity can take place. So this is a CC construction. Here we can see the foundation piles, which are the end bearing pile, which will be transferring the load of the structure to the sea bed. These are the end bearing piles for transferring the load. Next, sheet piles are those piles which are for retaining the water. And basically, they come into picture while we are constructing the structure under water. Next, rubble are the stones which have been placed here for a measure of increasing the stability of the structure and to make sure that there is no any overtopping of this structure. This is the ground surface which has been shown, and rubbles have been placed for stability. Sea wall is this CC construction. These are the waves which will be imparting the force on the sea wall. So sea wall will be ultimately handling the force for the impact of these waves. This is the width of the sea wall, which will vary depending upon the situation, depending upon the condition. That is, what sort of force or impact is it supposed to sustain? What amount of activities will be carried out? And ultimately, what is the design of this specific structure? So whenever the effect of waves is high, high intensity waves are there for long duration, in that situation this sea wall construction is done, which is to make sure that there is no erosion, there is no effect of these waves on this land portion. So sea walls are structures constructed parallel to the shore to develop demarcating line between land area and water area, as we have seen in the previous image. Used where land to be protected is developed one, and wave effects are seen. But also we have seen that ultimately where the impact of waves are severe, that is high intensity for long duration, there the sea walls are constructed, and where the land is to be protected, it is a developed one with a certain amount of human activity, cargo, commodity movement. Walls are massive and expensive, that is the CC construction. Sheet piles are driven into sea bed, that is at the time of construction and for detaining the. This is the view for sea walls. This is the land portion, water portion, and these are basically the waves which are imparting force on this sea wall. Again, this is the land portion, that is for movement. This is the water body, and here this is the sloping structure, that is the sea. And waves are imparting force on this sloping structure. Next are the bulkheads used where wave action is less severe. So, sea wall is constructed where the wave action is severe, while bulkheads are constructed where the effect of wave is not that much severe. Less expensive than sea walls. Along shoreline, we made the encroachment of sea by wave action. First of all, let us see the image of the bulkhead. So, the structure which has been constructed, that is vertical structure, is the bulkhead. This is the land portion. This is the water portion. So, basically where the wave action is less severe, in that case, this bulkhead are constructed to sort of make sure that there is no erosion of the land portion. Derive support from soil into which piles are driven. So basically the end bearing pile, it pass on the load to the soil, and basically the soil is the seabed that is supporting this end bearing pile, the vertical structure. Walls may be made of timber, steel or concrete, but mostly steel is used, and next to it timber is used. So these are the three constituents. Also here these rubbles are placed as a measure to mitigate the effect of the waves. Next again, these are the for bulkheads that are the vertical structure which will be retaining the land on one side, water will be on another side, which is will be at the lower level, and it will make sure that there is no erosion of land portion taking place. Next are the groins. First of all, let us see the image of the groin. So this perpendicular structures the shore are termed as groins. Basically, their function is trapping of the sediments inside them so as to make sure that the displacement of the sediments do not take place, and by making sure that the displacement is not taking place, the profile of the beach is preserved and also the beach itself is preserved. So, these are the wooden structure which are perpendicular to the shore, which will be trapping the sediments inside them so as to make sure that the profile of the beach is not changing. Because if these structures are not present, then there is a topic, that is the littoral drift, which we will be studying in chapter number 3 in detail. But basically, littoral drift is a phenomenon in which due to the wave action and the current action, the sediments along the land, which along the profile of this beach, are sort of getting displaced, and the profile of the beach is getting changed, and where this littoral drift is more, there even the beach itself can get eroded. So to protect that, these groins are constructed. Built to protect beach by littoral drift. Repeating again, this topic we will be studying in detail in the next chapter, that is chapter 3. But right now, littoral drift is basically related to the movement. Drift means movement. That is the movement of the sediments. Littoral means along the length. So basically, that is the sort of, we can say, movement of the sediments along the length of the beach. Made perpendicular to shoreline, extends in water. So accomplish that purpose or meaning. Made of wood generally. So purpose, that is stabilize the beach by making sure that the profile of the beach is preserved. Reduce the littoral drift, we have discussed already. Trapping material, that is the sediments. So as I told that the sediments or the soil particles will be trapped inside these groins, reducing the rate of loss of material. So as those material that are the sediments are being trapped in the groins, it will be making sure that there is as much less loss of material as possible around the beach. Next protection work is the revetment. Is a sort of providing support, and riprap is the rubbles which are being placed. So basically they are placed on the slope, and the purpose is, as we have seen, that to make sure that the erosion on the land portion does not take place. If the rubbles are not placed on this slope, then due to the wave action, this land portion will get eroded, and failure can also take place. place if the slope becomes critical. This is the view for riprap revetment. Protects land from wave erosion. Stone revetment is usually preferred, that is the rubbles are placed on the slope supported by the earth bank, that is beneath the rubble there is the slope which is existing, the earthen slope which is existing, which is the support to the rubble. Selection of stone size is vital, as resistance of stone is proportional to its volume. So as much higher dimension stone is, more will be its stability. So that selection of the size of the stone is vital with reference to the stability. So that is the same point which has been discussed already regarding the stability. Stones are less stable on steep slope. Larger stones are needed to resist action of higher waves. So if the slope is more steeper, then the stability of the stone will get affected and they will sort of not be positioned properly. Large stone will resist the action of higher waves. That is a self understood point. Thin layer as compared to the rubble mound. Now we have seen the rubble mound at deep water, but here the layer of the rubbles which have been placed is very thin as compared to the layer of the rubble mound type. Next, again, this is the image for riprap revetment. Here, there are two layers of rubbles that are stones which have been shown. These are the crush stone, that is the small size rubble, and these are the large size rubble, that is the riprap which is represented. The large size rubbles are used on the top layer because the voids will be present due to the large size, and through the voids, the water will seep or pass, and by passing through it, by sort of colliding, they will dissipate or reduce the energy, as we have seen in the case of rubble mound and lake water. Due to the presence of voids, the water will seep through, and by passing through, by collision of the water amongst through those voids through the rubble, they will sort of dissipate, reduce the energy. And the bottom layer is consisting of small size rubbles, because here do not need voids, because if here voids are present, then water will seep through this void. So these are the small size rubbles, so the voids or the empty space is also less and the water cannot seep through. Also, the slopes have been shown, that is the slope for placing the large size rubble, that is 1:2, and the slope for placing the small size rubble, that is second beneath layer, this is the top layer. So talking about revetment, basically here the rubbles have been shown. This is the land portion, this is here the water body is existing. So when the water level exceeds during the high tide situation, this sloping structure where the large size rubble are placed, and they will dissipate the energy of wave of the water and make sure that no effect the waves are pronounced on the land side.